Yo, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all the other episodes, stop by raprankings.com or search Rap Rankings on your favorite podcast platform. Track 2, Ruff Ryders Anthem, aka a huge fucking hit. Okay, no matter what Billboard tries to say.
One of the biggest hits we've ever heard in our lives.
One of the biggest hits, perhaps the biggest. You know, in 1998, it was at the top of the charts. They say it wasn't, but I was there. Okay. Produced by Sliz Beats. Okay. 7+.
Deep AF, my dog.
Wow, 7+.
I'll explain. Because I was for show. Yeah, I was literally for show. It was going to be higher. I thought it was going to be at least an 8-.
Like, 7+. So this is nothing compared to some of those Lupe songs we heard.
This is 2 points below... Logic and Childish Gambino driving Miss Daisy.
Got it.
I'm just speaking my truth, man.
Yeah, and sometimes your truth sucks. Okay. You know? And I'm there to, for all the people who hear your truth and they think this guy's truth is some of the worst truth I've heard. I need to be there to be like, guys, don't worry. I agree. You know?
Okay.
His truth is nonsense sometimes. Sometimes. I agree with your truth sometimes. It's good truth. You know, we know the dark side of Mel's truth.
Okay. Well, what is your truth?
My truth is this is not my favorite song on the album.
Oh, okay. Okay.
It's just not.
I mean, I don't think that would be controversial. Merely,
but it comes real close. 9-. Deep AF, my dog.
Deep AF, my dog.
Okay, you love it. All right, I've been showing up again. Well, look, I was shocked by the 7+, but it was one of those situations where you know a record. You know it in your heart. You've heard it plenty of times. And because of that, you assume you like it a lot. You assume it's going to be an 8. The reason why it isn't because of DMX. Everything he's doing, I remember. Like I remember liking. I heard the record. I'm like, yep, still like this stuff. This is what sunk it to a 7+, okay? I never remembered the mix being this bad, which makes sense because I didn't know what a mix was until like the late 2000s, right? So when I'm hearing this in the car as a kid.
This guy's a mix whore.
I'm a mix slut, okay?
All right, this is what he is. If a mix isn't good enough for him, he's going to bury a song.
I'm a, what do you call it, size queen? I'm a mix queen, okay? Like, now, look, granted, I know we messing with some rough music. This is Ruff Ryders.
Yeah, this is okay? Rough,
so,
and rough.
I understand, right. And so, you know, the aesthetic, if you will. God, I hate the word. It's so overused, but it's valid. There's some leniency there. You know, it's rugged hip hop. It's not supposed to be pristine and squeaky clean.
That's why I was saying on the last record we just did, the intro, sometimes the rawness and like unfinished sound of some of these beats.
Mm-hmm.
Benefits DX, yeah. Like, because yeah. It matches his tone and his energy and his style very well,
right? You know, and yeah, that's the case on a lot of songs on here. It's just I was a victim of my own, I guess, you know, realization, like the come to Jizo moment, okay? Because it's like I'm going into this record, I'm like, oh, Ruff Ryders Anthem, it's for sure a takeaway, and it is. But it wasn't what I thought it was going to be. This is the problem. I wish the bass line wasn't warbling. I wish it wasn't this distorted kick bass balance.
I have literally one note, and it's why I throw the minus on there.
Okay.
And this is Mel during the Blueprint review when we did You Don't Know, which Just Blaze backed up your sentiments. And I agreed as well that it doesn't knock like it's supposed to.
Right.
I feel like the kick is being suppressed somehow.
Yeah. I come into this expecting, you know, stop, drop, like, it's been a knock, and it's
how
it's
loud
really
do you listen
just,
to this music, though?
I only turn it up past my car, my chosen car volume of 39. 39 what? I don't know. And that's my message to the car company. 39 what? It's not decibels. Yeah, I always say they never have a value. What is the unit of measurement here? Okay.
I would prefer that as well, because, like, yeah, 39 what? I'm sure every car and every stereo is slightly different.
Right. 39 in my car might not be 30. It probably isn't 39 in your car, or anyone else's car, but I keep it on 39 unless the album is, like, older and it's mastered at a certain volume, then I'll turn it up because I have to, you know? But this wasn't a mastering issue. Everything was loud enough. It was just distorted. And I'm just like, man, it's supposed to be knocking, but it's really just like
raw materials, though. Think about the equipment that's being used here for these beats. This is like Casio keyboards and shit, you know?
On that note. So this is what I was saying. The Smoking Gun and a little bit about the beat. So the Bad website said in an interview with Vibe magazine in 2000, Swizz Beatz said this about the anthem. He said, "That was my first major hit, but it took me a week to convince DMX to do the song. He was in the studio acting a fool. He was like, 'I don't want those white boy beats. I'm not rapping over that shit.'" That's what he said. Okay. Now, here's the thing. I don't know if you noticed. My first major hit is what he said. Okay. Now, a major hit is not peaking at 93 on the Billboard Hot 100. A major hit is at least top 40. Well, now, he could have just been speaking colloquially, but...
No. Now, maybe he has his dates mixed up, but there were two singles that came before this.
Mm-hmm. There was Get At Me, Dog, and Stop Being Greedy.
So this is the third song, but Get At Me, Dog, and Stop Being Greedy both charted much higher than this did.
Swizz produce those?
No.
Oh, okay. We'll see then.
My hunch is that maybe there's some truth to this theory that we have and that DMX is recounting, you know, that if he's saying that was his first major hit, but then again, what do we mean by hit? Do we mean by plaques, or do we mean by people playing the song off the CD in cars, out of car stereos,
out vibes, of boom boxes? Basically, like what the streets are saying. Is it a street hit? Are you,
because
are
I'll you... tell you it was. It was. There were other DMX songs prior to Ruff Ryders Anthem that got mixtape burn, and maybe it got more radio spins overall, but I can promise you it wasn't getting burned in the streets like that. People weren't blasting it out of car stereos and boomboxes the way they were with Ruff Ryders Anthem.
Right. You know, and I mean, it was a culture hit. Like I'm saying, these are not false memories. I remember being on the schoolyard with the other kids saying, "Stop, drop, shut them down, open up shop." I was there. I remember it. You can't tell me this didn't happen.
I mentioned in part one that someone on the bus asked me who made the song "Stop Being Greedy, Give to the Needy," but DMX Ruff Ryders Anthem was playing on the bus every day.
Right. You know, so, I mean, now here's the thing, too, that I think when he says first major hit, he could mean hit, you know, relative to previous songs of his. Like maybe number 93 on the Billboard is a hit compared to every other beat.
Yeah,
prior
but why wouldn't something doing like 2-3 times better than that in Get At Me, Dog be his first major hit in his mind?
Well, this is Get At Me, Dog. Who produced it? That's the thing. It wasn't Swizz, right?
No, Swizz only did Ruff Ryders Anthem.
Right.
Maybe
so he
one
wouldn't
other
be comparing himself to the other singles. He's comparing himself to himself. You know?
Oh, Swizz said it was his first major hit.
Yeah, Swizz. Oh no, yeah, not DMX. Swizz.
Right.
Said this,
right. You okay. Know? Well, it was his first.
It was
major
a hit. I'm not just going to roll over, okay, dog pun intended, for this idea that Ruff Ryders Anthem was peaking at number 93. And that doesn't, no, okay? No, I refuse. Listen, we're in the age of, like, alternative truth, right? They're trying to give me some alternative truth, and I'm not standing for it, okay? This had to have charted higher. I may just enlist Dart. I may pay him to look into this for me, because I don't believe it, okay? It's not real. The song was too ubiquitous. Okay, so with all of that said, okay, the verdict's out until I scrounge up some funds to pay Dart.
One sec. I'm popping open iTunes for a second.
Oh shit.
Hold on a second.
Okay.
He said, wait, you got chart results and chart data in iTunes? No, not that insane with my
tagging. Do they even have a column for that metadata?
I'm just trying to see. I'm trying to see, like, was he on a Now compilation? Oh, wow, he wasn't.
He wasn't?
Why did I think he was on a Now compilation?
Because he was huge? Okay, no. Hold on. Now.
No, I have now. Hold on. I'll tell you how many Nows I got.
I mean, maybe they were fronting on him because, you know.
I got Now 1 through 23. Okay?
Okay.
He ain't on no Nows.
That's crazy.
Why did I think he was on Now? Party Up wasn't on a Now CD?
That's what I was about to say. Party Up wasn't there?
No, I something is happening. Something is happening.
They're messing with the timeline, all right? I hate to bring up the timeline, but it's like, this is...
You're telling me there weren't edited versions of Party Up and Ruff Ryders Anthem on various different Now CDs? Fuck you. They were.
You know what? No. It had to be. Because in the fifth grade, I performed... No. Okay, hold on a second. No, this is facts. In my music class in the fifth grade, and it was off the Now CD. I know it was.
What did you perform?
What was it? It might have been Party Up. Hold on. Yeah, it had to be Party Up. How does Party Up go?
Y'all gonna make me lose my mind.
Yes!
Up in here,
yes!
up in here.
No, and here's the thing.
That's his biggest record. That's his number one biggest song.
Right, and here's the thing. I performed it, and I didn't know the lyrics. So I embarrassed myself. I knew the hook. Mm-hmm. That's all I knew. So it had to be there. It was on the Now CD. I performed it in the fifth. Somebody go in and talk to my what was her name? I don't remember her name. Go to Edison Middle School.
Shannon oh, you L. know what? No, it's on Now. That's what I call 2000s hip hop.
Okay, well that was Now. Maybe it was that. Okay, was Ludacris also on there?
Wait, hold on. When did that come out? No, that came out this year.
What?
Yeah, Party Up is on Now. That's what I call 2000s hip hop, which is this year.
Okay, listen, no.
It's not on any Now compilation.
This is cap. I don't believe this. Where's Sammy?
My dog.
Are you shitting me right now?
I'm not shitting. Dude, I'm having the same revelation, basically, is like, what, where, how, when, why?
Wait, so what did I perform? I don't think anybody brought in the DMX album. Let alone...
No. I know for a fact that whoever was playing Ruff Ryders Anthem on the school bus had the clean version of the album. Whoever it was who was playing that CD out of the boombox every single day.
Okay, so in 2004, when I was doing Y'all Gonna Make Me Lose My Mind up in here, apparently that wasn't off of a Now CD.
Was it off a burned CD? And
it could have been that. Maybe somebody brought it in, you know? Maybe it was my man Trayvon. My man.
Hey, that's...
Okay?
That single is also on DMX's highest-selling album.
Right.
And then there was X, I believe.
So there was no DMX on any Now compilation until the one that dropped this year. Now that's what I call music 2000s hip hop.
Correct. I have Now 1 through 23, the US versions. Because, you know, there's like all the UK ones as well. I'm not paying attention to that.
Okay. Well, I think that there is some timeline tomfoolery afoot.
Okay? Nelly's there's... on the Nows.
Well, yeah. And Pimp Juice and Us, right? Like, yeah. But DMX.
Well, no,
Eminem,
shockingly, is also not on there at all.
No, he's on a Now. He's on 6. Well, D12 is. My band is.
Yeah,
Now 16 has my band. There's no Eminem on any of the Nows.
I'm going to do another search right now on Now.
Dang.
I only have 1 through 23.
I've been vouching for
that goes only till 2006.
I've been vouching for that compilation my whole life, but I'm here to say I've decided that's not what you
now
call
music. Now
it's Cat. That's not what you call music.
Okay. Yeah. The only solo Eminem song is Mockingbird on volume 19.
Okay. Well, you know what? Maybe it's what you call music. It's just not all music. It's what you call
music,
though.
They missed his first three albums. They went straight to Encore.
Well, he was a controversial man until he started making lullabies for his daughter.
Right.
The controversy
kind of I would say excited. Less controversial, just but less yet, approachable. I guess not.
He wasn't white. Yeah, guess, he was gruff.
Yeah, know? I guess just not like cut out for the world of now. But if, I mean, come on, they got how many Chingy songs? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 5 Chingy songs.
Hold on, they got, right there. Did they got one call away? Did they got one call away? That was now Ball 16, baby, right?
Pulling me back. Yeah, that's now 16.
Yep. Yeah, a, I, look, see, I know that rap. Now 16. My band, One Call Away, we got Slow Motion for a man. Juvenile, okay? It's some joints on there, on that Now 16.
Bow Wow, they got Let's Get Down, Like You, and Fresh As I'm Is. Black Eyed Peas, obviously, like, I'm not even going to count them because they were making, like, straight-up pop music.
They are now. Yeah.
Let's see. Wow, only one Akon song between volumes 1 and 23? Well, I guess, like, 06, which is... when this cut off, like, Akon was still kind of moving. They got one Jadakiss song, Why, featuring Anthony Hamilton.
That's crazy 17. That they have a Jadakiss song on it. And Why was a hit. Yeah, I love Why. But, yeah. Like, you have Jadakiss Jaquan, but no DMX?
Obviously, it's not Jaquan Tipsy, though. It's Jaquan You and Me. I don't even know what that is. They don't have Tipsy.
I'm thinking of Cassie.
This ain't music. This ain't now.
No, they this should be... They should retitle
my band.
It.
I'm now 16. D12 my band.
Yeah. They should Bubba retitle Sparks, it.
Miss
now,
Me Booty, I'm 22.
Now, that's what I call music, but not comprehensively. That should be the full title. Yeah. Now, that's what I call music, but not comprehensively.
Eve, two of them, Gangsta 11, Let Me Blow Your Mind.
They better not have freaking Tambourine on there and not have.
No, they're not. Well, then again, I don't think I go back far enough on the nows to comment on that. Like, the last now that I have with 23, I think came out like Christmas 06.
Folks. Let's see.
Anyone else?
The point is, for some reason, now.
Three Jay-Z's?
Like, of course. Of course.
They got now two has Hard Knock Life. Uh-huh. And also 03 Bonnie and Clyde and Excuse Me Miss on 12 and 13.
Okay. This is a
LL Cool J Love You Better classic.
It's a travesty. Yes, that's the word. It's a travesty.
Roll out Luda. Oh, four Ludas. Roll out, stand up, pimping all over
now,
the world.
Now roll out, definitely.
Oh no, three. That was Lumi D, not Ludacris. Missy Elliott, Lose Control, Only One Missy. That's crazy. No Get Your Freak On. I guess it's kids. You don't want kids getting their freak on. Two Nas songs, bro. Yeah, Made well, You Look okay. And I Can't.
Now, they don't know what they're doing over there, okay? I have a soft spot for now 4 and 16, but other than that, I don't know what they're doing. Okay?
Oh, my God. They basically released a Nelly Greatest Hits across, like, the first 23 volumes of this thing. An insane amount of Nelly. Two Snoop Dogs, Beautiful and Drop It Like It's Hot.
Just let's start the petition. Let's start the petition for them to retroactively add Ruff Ryders Anthem to now.
Look, Cam, I love you, pal. And you know what? I'm a fan of the 3-6 Mafia. But how the fuck do you have two 3-6 Mafia songs on the nows, but you don't have Ruff Ryders Anthem? They got Stay Fly, which obviously was a huge hit, and Pop In My Collar. Look, I love this song, but I don't think it was like now worthy, you know? That's when, like, the now people start getting a little silly. Will Smith, Switch. That's the only song he has on a now.
Now listen, Big Will. I mean, I turn around now, Switch. Boop, boop. Look, I like Switch, okay?
Hey! Switch. You know, the problem with Switch, it didn't end up becoming the Hitch song.
Was that what
it was supposed to be? You know how he used to do songs for all his movies?
Yeah, right.
So it was supposed to be Hitch.
So hey, Men in Black, hey. Black Suits Coming was Men in Black 2, Wild Wild West. So Hitch was supposed to, or Switch was supposed to be the Hitch song.
No, Switch was literally supposed to be called Hitch. Hey, no. Hitch.
Okay. If you say so, man.
And that's why, that's why they ended up putting the Usher song in the movie instead of Switch. But they're dancing to Switch. They're not dancing to Usher.
If you say so, man. I've only seen Hitch like once, so I don't remember.
Dude, play Switch over their dance scene.
Okay, you're getting in Charles Hamilton telling me to play the Penthouse Elevator over Eminem's music video for 3 a.m. for like hidden messaging. Okay. Like, yeah, we don't want to go down those kind of rabbit holes. All right.
The point is Ruff Ryders.
This is Ruff Ryders Anthem, and it was a huge hit.
It was okay? huge. It was bigger than half of those rap songs I named off on now.
Yeah. They're trying to tell me it wasn't, and it was. So here's
Holiday Inn by Chingy. Like, I saw the video a number of times on TV. People weren't playing that song.
I mean, I remember it, but I remember this more, okay? And
I mean, right there they were playing. They even played, what's it called? And You Were My Baby.
They were playing that. One Call Away.
Nobody gave a fuck about Holiday Inn. No one cared about that song. I was there.
Look,
I bought that album.
Why?
Jackpot? Chingy.
Jesus Christ.
DJ Quick had a beat on there.
Guy's name is Chingy.
Well, I wanted to hear the DJ Quick beat. Sue me. Man.
Okay. Well, we had Napster then. You could have pirated that.
Nah, I needed the CD. It's DJ Quick.
Oh, okay.
Got to get that Royalty high DJ. Fidelity audio.
Oh, okay. Well,
that's why I bought that Red Light District as well.
Okay. Well, folks, 7+. I like it. Bordering on liking it a lot. Me discovering that I don't like this mix is what kept it from an 8.
But you like the beat.
Bang. I like the beat. I do like the beat. Mm-hmm. I like the composition of it. I like the melody. I like the... I don't even think I dislike the drum selection. I was going to ask
you how you felt about, like, this beat. You know how we were talking when we did the Juvenile review? And I was saying, like, Back That Ass Up is a decent beat, but it's elevated by Juvenile, and it's why we get so hype when the song comes on.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of feel that way about this to an extent as well. Like, this beat is good, but it's DMX who takes this beat to new heights. And yes. When this song comes on, you can't help but just go crazy.
I wanted to go crazy. I couldn't go crazy the way I wanted to.
I'm still, all these years later, going crazy for this one.
It
still thrills me and fills me full of, like, this adrenaline by the end of the record where, like, you know... that, like, fucking, what's it called? Talk is cheap, motherfucker.
I love how it ends. Oh, that's great. DMX.
From the moment the record begins until it ends, I'm never not 100% invested. I just can't go 10 because A, I don't like the kick drum, and B, this is the ceiling for this record for me. It's not going higher than this.
I wanted it to bang. I wanted it to get me hype and energized and ready to
It could bang fight. More. I'll give it that.
It rattles. More. It doesn't bang. Mm. It rattles. Yeah. It's rattly, you know? And that's the problem with the mix. It should have been a better mix. But this song, the reason I do like it and have always liked it, it's because of DMX. This hook is obviously catchy. Schoolyard classic. But yep. it's a song of moments to me. Fun moments, and so, like, these are the moments that, like, always stuck out to me ever since I was a kid, up until now. You know, this moment number one. Okay, now this isn't a full, unlike now, I'll tell you, this isn't comprehensive, but nosy people get it too. When you see me spit at you, you know I'm trying to get rid of you. Yeah, I know it was pitiful. Like, that's a moment. I just like the way, yeah, I know it was pitiful.
I love his little conversational asides from the raps.
Oh, you think it's funny? Then you don't know me, money.
Don't know me, money.
That's moment number two. Okay. Moment number three. Okay. Oh, you thought you was raw? Boom! Not anymore. Okay. that's a moment.
With the explosion sound
with
as well.
With the explosion. You know, and obviously the setup, but what was that look for when I walked in the door? You know, like, it's confrontational. You got to love it. Okay. Oh, and this one, this used to pop me as a kid. Okay. Now stop a fan. Two more in the head. Got the four red. Yeah, that nigga's dead.
Very like dry said, humor, though, right?
Yeah, right. Conversation. It feels like it's very much in the vein of, like, oh, he ain't going to be in Rush Hour 3. You know, like, it's that kind of thing. And last moment. Yeah, there are more moments, but, you know, gotta make them groove, got them all like, ooh, got them all like, ooh, okay?
I'll throw out two more for you.
I'll throw some moments, throw some momos, okay?
Stop acting like a baby. Mind your business, lady. Oh, I love that.
Listen,
classic moment.
Okay, yeah, classic. Obviously, it's been turned into a meme. Okay, great meme, by the way. You know, when women tweet something.
And I love how he does the give a dog a bone, leave a dog alone, let a dog roam, and he'll find his way home.
Yeah, come on. You know, it's so not his fault. Money. You know, God, he did everything that I remembered him doing. It's just this beat disappointed me. In my head, it sounded a different way than it actually sounded.
The explosion is my favorite moment on the song.
The explosion, boom.
Boom, not anymore.
Yeah, you know.
Always pop huge for that. And of course, I mentioned the outro, just the, you know, the gun down.
Yeah.
And then the talk is cheap, motherfucker. Just how it comes right out from the chorus. God. I love how this is arranged. I have some archival audio for this.
Oh, well, hey, before you bring that in, I just want to tell them, you know, it's not all just moments. In my, listen now at 29 years old, there are some things that stuck out to me, just, you know, where I'm at in life. All I know is pain. All I feel is rain. How can I maintain with that shit on my brain? And I was like, thanks. Okay, here.
DPF, my dog.
Okay, like, it's simple, but yeah, okay. And the other thing, fucking with the wrong crew, don't know what we're going through. That line is more poignant than I think it may read on the surface, because this is how I live my life. Okay, you should never carry your inner turmoil out into the world to people, you know, who it's not their fault. You know, never lash out. But here's the thing, that's on you to do. That's your personal responsibility, but you can't control other people. And that's why you shouldn't just run afoul of people, because you never know what they're going through. And they might snap on you in a way that seems, you know, disproportionate to the situation. You know, you think you cut somebody off, it's not that big of a deal, nobody got hurt, they jump out the car and send three shots to your door. You know, because you never know what people are going through. Okay? So that line sticks out to me. You know, don't assume everybody's okay, because they're not.
7+, though, folks. 7+.
Well, just beat is rattling in my ear, in my speaker, and it's not banging. Like,
get a new car, man. Get a good car.
It's not. No. Listen, the better the speaker, the more distorted it would be.
That's true. It's the same thing with, like, a bad film transfer. The nicer the TV, the,
you know,
more they try to basically restore the film, the shittier it ends up looking.
Yeah, if the mix is muddy, you're just going to hear that mud in HD. So, yeah, but anyway, I mean, I want it to go 8, but 7+. It's a 7+. Maybe I'll stop being a mix queen one day, and it'll go up to the 8 that it should be. But, yeah. Archival audio,
right? I'm a mix queen when the situations call for it. If I get, like, a new D'Angelo album and the mix is bad, oh boy, we got a problem. We got a major fucking problem.
Well, okay? Here's the thing. I feel you on that, because you expect a certain quality for not only that artist, D'Angelo, but that style of music, you know? But
right.
I know that this is rough music, but this was a major hit. And you expect the hits to be clean sounding.
You still got to realize resources are somewhat limited.
Oh, man. While supplies last, ass beat. All right.
And I'm going to tell you something. DMX, as his career would progress, would continue to work with a lot of these people. But when he would get on stuff that's, like, better mixed, not necessarily going to yield a better song.
Yeah. What are you going to do, you know?
And there's, you know, like, there's levels to this shit, really. Like, I don't know, there's certain artists where if I heard a project and it wasn't mixed well, I'd be like, damn, that's a shame. And then there's some where I'm like, whatever, / it's somewhat beneficial. Like, I was saying, some of the rawness of this complements DMX. Whereas, on, like, late career Cam'ron stuff, I'm just like, why are you still recording in a tin can? Oh, I'm talking, man. Like, post-Killa Season, basically.
You know, I'm glad you brought that up, because I must say, to be a mix, I'm still pretty nice to people on the show in terms of the mix, because my catalog, my library of mix disses is extensive, okay? Just ask the group chat. I've told niggas, you mix this shit on an Etch-A-Sketch. Like, it can get deep, you know? I'm not going to go that far. I like Swizz beats, okay? But
I feel like a mix has to be truly awful for me to comment on
For me to pull out the big guns, the big insults, yeah, it has to be true. Yeah, this isn't an awful mix. It just...
It's flawed. It's a flawed mix.
It doesn't capitalize on the beat's potential. Hit the ice cream
drop, Mel.
Oh, the ice cream man's back? Ain't it like winter? What is he doing?
I live in California. There's no such thing.
All right.
Ice cream. How fucking original.
Wow. Now you are right. I was eating them snow cones all in December. Okay. In Oceanside. Whoo. My man will be posted outside. Oh my God. I wish I had one right now. Oh, that's the song.
The claps.
Oh. Yeah. What kind of hoedown ass ice cream music is that?
I don't know. He's probably not even selling ice cream.
Oh, selling them drugs. Like, what was it? Vice City. What was it? Mr. Whoopi? Mr.
Yeah, man.
You know? Yeah. Anyway. Yeah.
Get your moonshine. Get your meth.
Oh, I want to, damn. I wish the man hadn't shown up, because now I'm thinking about the snow cone with the gumball at the bottom.
Oh, at the bottom? Yeah.
Oh, my God. What I would do for one right now.
Keep moving, motherfucker.
What did DMX say? I think it was DMX on stage.
Oh, you know what? That might be Insano.
What?
My main man patron? Insano, my new henchman.
Yeah, the new patron.
Yeah.
What, in the ice cream?
Remember I was saying he's like that boy from Twisted Metals.
Oh, yeah, Sweet Tooth. Oh, I don't have this drop, okay? All right, I was going to say I would do anything for a snow cone right now, including fellatio. And then I remember DMX, I ain't never sucked a dick before in my life. I ain't never sucked a dick in my life. classic quote when he was on stage. But, yeah, anyway, don't let me. Don't let me derail this. I haven't, folks, I haven't eaten in over 24 hours. They said, Mel, you probably shouldn't have went into a review that malnourished. Well, I didn't feel hungry. And I'm trying to lose weight, so I'm like, fuck it, let's just do it, you know?
I don't think that's how you lose weight.
Yeah, fasting, right? You don't eat. And then your body starts eating the fat that already exists in your body, right?
You know? I don't think that's how it goes.
It was like, this man gonna fucking die. Just leave me here. No, I'm gonna make it. But yeah, listen, archival audio, right? You got archival.
Yeah, we have two pieces of archival audio for this one. Let's first listen to the remix of Ruff Ryders Anthem, which was on the DJ Clue professional album. Mm. And it features many of the roughest riders.
Okay, well, here we go.
This thing right here, yeah, yeah, is for my peoples in the streets with beats. And this thing right here, they get your ass off the street. Come on. They call me, drag on, it's time to pour them, burn them all. Till they all say, turn them all. Cause eat chips, I'ma hurt them all. Chicken ass, you know why I be the colonel. Cause I learn eternal, mixed with the inferno. So be careful, I learn you. You better learn, dude. Yeah, I heard you, but I'ma hurt you. But you don't know, my versus two is a virtue. Ruff Ryders be the team, which means a lot of cream, a lot of schemes, a lot of beams to make your stock drop right on the scene. This nigga here is too hot and too much for you to touch. But it tell your man, cause if two touch, then two will be two dust. Do you bust? Cause we do. You can ask people, but quietly. But they don't believe until they leave violently. Is you buying this? Cause niggas that purchase is under the dirt, kid. They call me Dragon. I'm the youngest, but get bonkers. Collab on with my dogs from Yonkers. But this Bronx bomber spit the flames. So you better, well, y'all gonna flame
on. Pull the drop up.
I miss the old hook.
Yeah, I do as well. I like some of the verses on there. It's like a flat 7.
Okay. Oh, well, here you go.
Deep AF, my dog!
But the man himself, Drag On, the youngest in charge, he spoke on the making of this album with one of our favorite members of the law enforcement community, Mr. DJ Vlad. He's
coming in and out of my house. Sorry, but you hear this?
Well, the garage. Listen, take it up with the homeowners.
I'm taking it up with my mans and them and get this man beat up for this. But yeah, okay. Well, here we go. Drag On is going to talk to us right about now.
Okay, so you join around 97, and then in 98, DMX started dropping albums.
Yep.
He dropped As Dark and Hell Is Hot.
Yep.
And that just hit the music scene like an atom bomb.
Yeah.
Were you in the studio with him when he was making that?
Yeah, I was with him. The Ruff Ryders had sent me and had bought a house in North Carolina, and they sent me and him to that house, and we had to stay there and work both on our albums, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I worked on Opposite of H2O, and then he worked on It's Dark and Hell Is Hot, and that's where we really became brothers right there, you know what I'm saying?
Right, because you two kind of even look alike, yeah, you know? Because I remember, I remember DMX even said, like, yeah, Drag On, he even looks like me.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
He looks like my little brother, like in real life.
Yeah, for real. No matter what, I was like his little brother the whole time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're working on It's Dark and Hell Is Hot. Well, DMX is working on it.
Yeah.
And you show up on the song For My Dogs.
Yep.
With you, DMX, of course, Big Stan, Loose, and Casino?
Yep, and Casino.
Casino, sorry. And that was the second song you ever recorded in your life.
Yeah. Wow, that's crazy you knew that. Yeah.
Do my research.
Yeah, for real. That's some research right there.
Yeah. Okay, so you put that song together. He's finishing up his album. Did you have any idea what was about to happen with that album?
I knew he was going to be successful. Where you found it? Like, I knew he was going to be that dude. Like, you know what I'm saying? You know, far as selling millions and stuff like that. Like, you know what I mean? You know, me being from my project and stuff like that, I just couldn't fathom those numbers for any of us. I was just happy to just be able that I got a chance to show the world what I can do. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't really expecting that song that I did for him. You know what I'm saying? Because I only had 8 bars, but it did so much for me, like, on the street. You know what I mean? It made everybody was like, that distinctive voice, who is this? You know what I'm saying? Because I'm on there with, like, 4 or 5 other people, but it did so much justice for me. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I learned is, I didn't know either. It's Casino?
Mm-hmm.
Because I was ready to say Casino later. Okay, well, the more you know. But I was, of course, looking up Drag On, too, because when he was like, you know, he was saying he looked like
they
DMX.
Look like,
yeah. I mean, it's certain photos, yeah. Certain photo. I see it. I see the resemblance. I can, it's not too off base. But yeah. Well, I wish he would have confirmed that this was a huge hit. But he spoke nothing.
Unfortunately, he wasn't aware of the narrative that we're trying to correct.
Folks, if you're listening, alert all of Ruff Ryders about this, because I'm sure they would know even more than we would how it truly performed. Okay? This is...
I'm just going to ask a question on Twitter. How in the fuck did was Ruff Ryders Anthem the lowest charting single of the 4 DMX singles from his debut? And you know what? Maybe someone will answer in the many hours we sit here to review this.
Maybe. Well, until then, only other note I have, at the top of the song, I said, the noises racists make when imitating people from Africa. So, yeah, I guess
that's Starvin' Marvin on South Park.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah. Yeah. Hold on, let me see. Cause this noise.
Yeah.
There you go. All right. Anyway. Yeah, you got anything else?
Not really. I mean, I think we've kind of covered this one pretty thoroughly. We can move on.
It's the anthem, okay? No matter what they say out there, it's the anthem.
Yo, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all the other episodes, stop by raprankings.com or search Rap Rankings on your favorite podcast platform.